This vid tip will explain how to generate good search terms, or how to modify your search to get more or less, but better results. And this is what I would do if I were working with you in person or in a class. So here's a question we're going to work with. This is a sample, your first research question. This is kind of what you're starting with. Do people read online magazines differently than they do print magazines? So the first thing you want to do is parse the question. Pick out keywords from the sentence, from the question, and the ones I've picked out are read, online, print, and magazine. So those are keywords that you could use in Google or in preferably Communication and Mass Media Complete. What I would like you to do is consider the relationship between the concepts. So this is the next thing to do for thinking about how to parse the question into language that the search engine can understand. So first of all, I would argue that read and magazines are unique concepts, so we should link them with and. And print and online are similar concepts, so we should link them with or. And I'll show you what I mean with a Venn diagram. Remember Venn diagrams from like fifth grade? So we have read, we have magazine, so those are anded together. And then in the bottom circle, we're oring online or print together. And then to translate this to search engine language, it would look like this. In the search box in Communication and Mass Media Complete, and that's the same as writing it all out in one line with parentheses around the things that you're oring together. And I'm hoping your math people will figure that out. You can do it either way, it's exactly the same results. So we did the search, and then my first question to you is going to be, how many results did we get? And you'll see we got 43 results. And so the Venn diagram then has 43 results at the intersection of these three concepts. And my question to you is that a good number? 43 results, reading, magazines, print, online. I don't really think so. I think there should be a lot more, particularly in a database like Communication and Mass Media Complete. So, how do we get more results? This is the really important part. So, how do we revise our keywords, change things around so we get more results? And the first thing I want to show you is using the truncation symbol or the wildcard symbol, which is the asterisk. And you see here that read asterisk will get read, reading, reader, readership. It'll also get irrelevant things like ready, but that's okay. We'll start with read and the asterisk. Magazine and the asterisk does the same thing. Later on, we'll talk about oring terms together and looking at database search terms to get more ideas. So here's the Venn diagram with the truncated keywords and how it translates to the search engine. So basically, you're just putting the asterisk at the end of the word you want to truncate in your search terms. This does not work in Google. It doesn't work in Google Scholar, just FYI. It works in pretty much all the library databases. And when we do that, we get 326 results. So that's a lot. I still am kind of thinking we might want to try and get some more articles. We talked about using the truncation wildcard, and now what I want to do is come up with even more search terms and or them together to get more results. So what we can do is brainstorm synonyms and related terms. So for the purpose of reading in print versus online for a magazine, I would argue that the problem is very similar to what newspapers are going through. So reading newspapers in print versus reading newspapers online. So if you're interested in how this works in magazines, you should also be looking at how this works in newspapers. And then later we'll talk about database search terms. So if we do read truncated, magazine truncated, newspaper truncated, and online or print, we get 769 results. Next question you should ask yourself, is that a good number? Again, probably not. It's too many results to go through. I suspect that there are a lot of what we call in library jargon false positives or articles that aren't relevant. So now what do? And we don't want to get more anymore. We want to refine our results. We talked about these two options, and now what we're going to do is look at the database search terms for more ideas. And the best way to do this is to look at this, the thesaurus term subject box over on the left-hand side of EBSCO. This goes back to earlier what I said about looking outside the box. Really, really important. So here we have part of the left-hand box from EBSCO, and you see the number of results up at the top and a couple of other options. And then I clicked on the down triangle to open up the thesaurus terms. And if we click on Show More, we'll get even more results. And so these are additional terms that you can use to refine your search. So you can think here about some of the terms that might be really useful for you. And you can recognize them with your eyes and your brain, but they're, because databases are so literal with search terms, you might be missing some of these. So we can refine your search. The same concept, but using different words. So instead of read, let's look at readership. That might be useful. We added newspaper to magazine, and maybe let's add in websites to online and internet. So what we're putting them together with ORs. And then my real recommendation here is that let's focus on the online first. So how do people read online? So the most common articles in this set are looking at online news, so we'll do that first. And we're setting aside the concept of print, and we'll come back to it. So using these different words, readership, magazine or newspaper, and internet or online or websites, we get 108 articles. So I hope you see how that's working. I'm not saying that these are the be-all and end-all terms. I'm not saying that at all. I'm trying to teach you how to be flexible with search terms and change them around to make them more useful for you and to get different results and hopefully more relevant results. The other thing you should be doing is looking at the subjects assigned to the articles that you like. And this is from the results list. And if you'll see here, a lot of these subjects might be useful, might not be useful. Whales, you probably don't care about. On the other hand, news websites is a lot more precise than just websites, so that might be useful to you. And then here's another one, print versus online use. So even though we didn't add the word print in, we're still getting articles comparing print and online, so that might be useful. And you get this subject heading, newspapers research. So that might be useful. Even though you're looking for magazines, if there's research about how people read newspapers in print versus online, that will be relevant to the work you're doing with magazines. I strongly encourage you to keep track of your search terms like we've just been going through. So read with the asterisk, readership. Readership surveys is a new one, might be useful. Magazine with an asterisk also leads to newspapers, which leads to newspapers research, might be useful. We started with online or internet. We're adding in news websites. So keep track of these and cross off the ones that don't work, write down the new ones, and then redo your search with new terms. You'll want to try these in different databases like CMMC, PsycINFO, and some of the others that we've talked about. When you go into new databases, you'll be suggested, you'll get the idea to look at new terms. So I would recommend lather, rinse, and repeat. So I hope this has been helpful. As always, ask me any questions that you have. This is complicated, but I'm happy to help, and stay tuned for more VIT tips.